Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Keeping History on Two Wheels, where we give you the side stories that make the larger story more complete. You know, the one that you already know, well, we're going to give you the information on the side that makes that one a little bit more complete and will make it stick in your mind just a little bit better. Who would have known that Bonnie and Clyde, 85 years later, would still be playing Robin Hood? Stick with us and we'll find out. By the way, if you like this video, click right over here, the subscribe button. It's the red one on the bottom. Also, remember to hit that bell so that you'll get a notification whenever we do an upload, and we do one each and every Sunday at 1 o'clock.
This thing was on, wasn't it? I hope so.
Okay, guys, this one's going to be unscripted, and we're just going to have a conversation, so to speak. A year ago, I started season one and had absolutely no idea what the heck I was doing. I didn't know how to edit. All I knew was I had a camera, I had a mic, I had a GorillaPod, and said, you know what, I'm on the bike, let's go for a ride and let's start teaching some folks about some history. And season one has come back to bite me in the butt. It's been a great one though. If you're ever gonna get bitten in the butt, this is the way to get bitten in the butt. So last year during season one, I was doing two uploads a week. I was in Little Rock, and so I was covering everything. Arkansas, Texas, Louisiana, Oklahoma. And so I had a 3-day weekend, and I said, you know what? I'm gonna hit the road. And Bonnie and Clyde roam this area. Let's go find out some things about Bonnie and Clyde. And so I went down to Gibbsland, Louisiana. And if nobody knows where Gibbsland is, it's just outside of Shreveport. It is a little bitty town, but they have some great people there. And I'll get into that in just a minute. But so Gibbsland is where Bonnie and Clyde were finally killed 85 years ago. And anyway, the story of Bonnie and Clyde reads a lot like Robin Hood. Not to glorify them in any way, because what they did was horrendous, but they did it to who they believed were oppressing the normal day, everyday Joe on the street. It's the Depression. A lot of people blame the banks for the situation that the U.S. was in at the time. Farms were being foreclosed on left and right. Sharecroppers and farmers were all of a sudden finding themselves in major metropolitan areas like Dallas and Houston and all, trying to find work. And the work just wasn't there to be had. A lot of people nowadays think that Bonnie and Clyde were just roaming around, robbing any little gas station. The movie that's out now, The Highwayman, with Kevin Costner and Woody Harrelson, there's a scene in there where Ma Ferguson, which is played by Kathy Bates, says that Bonnie and Clyde robbed a gas station for $4 in a tank of gas, and that's just not the case. They were holding up gas stations that were owned by the bigger gas companies, not the mom and pops. Clyde had if you want to call it a moral standard about not robbing the mom and pops, because they reminded him of his own father and mother who owned a gas station there in West Dallas. And when they robbed the banks because, number one, they were easy targets out in the middle of nowhere. And also, everybody was blaming the banks at the time for the depression and the situation that all these farmers were in. So he kind of had this moral code that those were the guys he was going after. Anyway, 85 years later, Clyde's helping out the little guy again. Last year, when I did the video of going down to Gibbsland, Louisiana, and visiting the kill site for Bonnie and Clyde, and then 2 weeks later, got the opportunity to interview Buddy Barra, which is Clyde Barra's nephew, I had no idea that a year later, or actually about 9 months later, that was actually going to come back to help my channel. I didn't think anything about outside circumstances that were going to help my channel with those two videos. Let me explain. Last year when I did those videos, I had about 30 subscribers. I was plugging along, doing two episodes a week and just not really feeling like I was getting anywhere. But I kept plugging away. Just kept plugging and kept plugging and kept plugging. And like I said, I didn't know anything about editing. Didn't know really anything about footage storage, my data storage, and ended up in some situations now that I wished I hadn't have ended up in. I went down and did the episodes, one in Gibbsland, one in Dallas, and put them out. And those two were probably my best at the time as far as viewerships and causing subscribers. And even though Perry Carver of the Bonnie and Clyde Ambush Museum, he's the curator and the owner of the Bonnie and Clyde Ambush Museum in Gibbsland, Louisiana, told me at the time that they had been in Gibbsland filming The Highwayman with Kevin Costner and Woody Harrelson. And it didn't really click to me that this movie was going to be coming out. And here I was, absolutely not knowing anything of what I was doing and just thinking I was cranking out another episode for that, you know, another two episodes. And I put them up and really didn't think anything else about them. Just kept plugging. Now, also at the same time, I had a catastrophic failure with my storage devices. I only had them backed up once, and that backup crashed, and I was unable to pull any footage off of it after that fact. Now, when I did the episodes, I mixed in music, and not knowing anything about editing, I mixed the music too loud. You can still hear them, and they're clear, but the music is kind of overpowering and it really does do the videos an injustice. There was some great information came out of those videos, but I'm tooling along. It's, you know, like I said, 9 months later, and Netflix puts out The Highwayman. That show aired on Netflix for the first time on March 29th. And let me tell you, on March 19th, I still only had 105 subscribers. And overnight, the Bonnie and Clyde, Buddy Barra interview, the bad one, because I had mixed music with it and the music was too loud. Now, I had also done a more YouTube-friendly with B-roll in it, you know, all that type stuff. I had done a edited version, and the music was a lot lower in that one, so it was fine. But for some reason or another, YouTube decided that it would push the unedited version, and even though it got a lot of views and they were watching it, most of them were watching it all the way through. There were some I was getting, you know, comments on there that they could only watch it for 12 minutes, they could only watch it for 16 minutes, and this was an hour and 20 minute interview. So, you know, I was having to redirect them, if I could, over to the edited version. On March 29th, I had about 115 or so subscribers, and it is now April 12th, and I have 323 subscribers of 904%. Over the last month, I have added 231 subscribers over the 23 subscribers last month. So that's a lot, at least for my channel anyway. My channel is very small, and to see that kind of an increase, I was freaking out. My watch time minutes for this month is 618,889 minutes versus the 13,202 minutes the month before. That's a 4,588% increase. My views for the month is 37,201 views versus 1,614 last month. That's a 2,205% increase. Even though it's slowing down a little bit now, it's still going strong. Mostly off those two videos, the Perry Carver interview in Gibbsland and the Buddy Barra interview in Dallas, Texas. Now, the Buddy Barra one is the one that really is going through the roof. So my point this morning, gotta get my coffee, is don't ever take any one of your videos that you're doing as just being a filler for the week. Try and make each one of them as if that's gonna be the one that's gonna blow up for you. You're not always gonna know how to do things, but do the things that you can do to the best of your ability, because you never know when something's gonna sneak up on you and bite you in the butt. At the same time, without even realizing it, I put out to the No Small Creator group that I'm in, which is a great bunch of folks, that I wanted channel audits done. I wanted people in the group to take a look at my channel and see where I could improve on my channel page, my channel videos, how I'm doing my tags, all that stuff. I wanted them to look at it all and then give me feedback on that so that I could do improvements on my channel and how I do things. And let me tell you, sometimes you need to have your big boy pants on, because they're gonna say things to you that you really don't wanna hear. But they're a great bunch of folks, and let me tell you, they do it with compassion. There were some things that I really needed to take care of that I thought were of no consequence, really. And they really do make a big difference. And my No Small Creator group that I'm a part of, I love them to death, because they came back and they were like, with all love and care, this is what you need to work on. To have it phrased that way makes you take it a little better, but you know what's coming whenever they do that, you know? It's kind of like in the military when we go, with all due respect, sir, pull your head out your ass. Anyway, enjoy what you're doing and do it to the best of your ability, because you never know what's gonna come back and what's gonna help you. I can't believe that 85 years after their death, Bonnie and Clyde are still giving back to the little guy. And let me tell you, there's a true story to that. Clyde used to steal cars go rob banks. Then he would take the money from the bank, go up to a dealership or somebody who is selling a car, and actually buy a car and give it to somebody else while he's pulling up at the lot in a stolen car. Some of y'all might not have realized it, but Perry Carver talked about it in our interview, where he turned around and said that the truck that Ivy Metfin was driving the day that they set up Bonnie and Clyde just outside of Gibbsland, Louisiana, is a truck that was bought and paid for and given to him by Clyde Barra. That's why Clyde would have recognized the truck. Go figure. But 85 years later, Bonnie and Clyde and Netflix is sending my subscribership and my watch time minutes through the roof, comparatively speaking. So have a great day. And remember, every trip starts with a step, and that step starts with you. Please subscribe.